welcome. We have Darcy Lama, who's here with us today, and this is our first time having a public speaker of this magnitude come in. And
it's my first time too.
Well, good. I can take that question. Yeah. We have a couple of questions for her, and so our first question would be, what sparked your interest about coming to Denver Women's Facility today?
Well, basically, when people come to me, it's because they want their life to be better.
The opportunity presented itself, and I just felt like this was the place my heart was calling me.
Better might be more work-life balance. Better might be stronger relationships with less conflict.
And to be able to share the message that I share on the outside with other people in corporations, in teams, doing life coaching, to be able to bring that message here to these women who are looking to grow and to make the most of every day, regardless of whether they're inside or outside or where they are, was truly, I felt like, the best gift I could have received. To be able to bring my message here to these women who are really committed to increasing their personal development and leadership and self-growth.
What are some of the effects that you and your family have to face, being that your husband is incarcerated?
What? My husband?
Oh, yes. It was absolutely the biggest nightmare of my life, the worst time ever. And I think I can safely say for my daughters, who are now 12 and 13 at the time, they were 8 and 9, and for myself, and also for John, my husband at the time.
There is a SWAT team and 50 police cars with guns surrounding your house, and they just took John out barefoot in handcuffs.
The level of stress and anxiety and fear and shame that we were all going through, and something that we'd never experienced before, was intense and hard, and there's no playbook for this. And I'm guessing for most of the women here that are residents.
And my life forever changed. It was
like all of a sudden, one moment with one phone call, life changes. And I think that part of the message of what I'm bringing here today, talking about being thoughtfully fit, really being thoughtful in every situation that you're in, is part of what helped me to get through this and to help our family to get through this. To the point now where my daughters are thriving, where John is really doing his own work in prison, and where I have come across and to the other side, and I have forgiveness in my heart for him, and compassion and mercy, and we're co-parenting in this really weird way that we are with him being incarcerated.
So I don't have to ask if you walk in forgiveness, because it's evident that you are walking in forgiveness right now.
It's been 3 years, 3.5 years since John was arrested. And I would never have guessed the level of love we have in our family and connection.
So forgiveness was and is and continues to be a choice.
How do you come up with your topics when you go into different places like this?
So I've been coaching now for about 15 years. I'm a life coach and an executive coach. And I started to notice that there are these themes.
And I found that there are 6 main obstacles. And I'm going to share those with you today. We're going to talk about them and see if any relate to you. You don't allow space to just have stillness, to just reflect, to think. So that's the first obstacle. The second obstacle, I don't always handle myself the way I'd like to. The third theme, I feel stuck. Fourth theme, I'd be fine if only you were different. The next obstacle, I have relationships that aren't working. And then the last obstacle or challenge is I react poorly when blindsided.
And so Thoughtfully Fit is a model I created that outlines these challenges and these obstacles that people deal with. I'm choosing based on the conversations. In this case, we did a pre-survey so that I could understand who are the women here that are going to be coming? What are their challenges and obstacles? And in this case, I'm going to be highlighting the core of the model, which is to pause and then think and then act. That's the core of the message today.
And finally, my last question to you. Do you see yourself coming back here to present again?
Oh, you are good. It would be truly an honor to come back and to present again.
Honor and the privilege to be joining you here today. I'm touched.
Hi, my name is Robin.
Hi, I'm Sandia Roberts.
My name is Cynthia.
And y'all women of influence, right?
Yeah, we are women of influence.
Can y'all tell us a little bit about the event today?
I think the event today is for life skills. It's to ensure women that we can empower one another.
How did you guys get involved with this group?
Well, I first heard about women of influence from the individuals who had already become a part of it. And I was asked to come on. Kind of a consulting capacity, just to bring to the table things that could be further offered to women of influence.
You said consulting capacity. What's your background?
Well, because I've been in prison for quite some time, so I had been a mentor before, and so my experience in incarceration has given me, you know, a wealth of knowledge as far as mentoring and dealing with children and young adults, individuals who had been through the correctional system but had not yet come to the adult correctional system.
I myself sought Damique out. I wanted to be a part of Women of Influence. I wanted to because I've already served 23 years on a life sentence, and I feel like I wanted to make a change and help people along the way. I feel like they need encouraging from the inside, and the only way we're going to do that is if it starts from the inside.
Let me ask you this. What are your hopes for today?
I believe that what Darcy is going to bring to us is a wealth of knowledge. And I think it's important for each individual who are going to be listening to Darcy is to realize their potential and understand that there's leaders in each and every one of us. And so it's imperative that we are focused on pulling out what I believe is already in us so that we can pass that along to help somebody else realize their potential as well.
What did you learn? What are you taking away? And what do you want to commit to?
I also think that it gets what is happening in here out into the world so that everybody can understand what is really happening, what's going on, and so we can empower each other to move beyond here and see what is out there and move beyond these walls.
How huge is this event for you? To have a speaker coming from the streets?
It's huge.
It's huge, and we're very excited.
Yeah.
We're very excited
and appreciative.
Anything you'd like to say to the people that made this possible, including yourselves?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for your time.
Part of Women of Influence, and what this program is about is about bridging the gap with the community inside and outside of prison. We're basically trying to live out everybody's dream by everybody collaborating different ideas on how to come up with different community projects and how to get those things to manifest and become a reality in our environment. And also, it's about working on different relationships, building relationships, and dealing with women issues and gaining life skills.
My name is Sarah, and I'll just kind of piggyback on that a little bit. So a lot of our program as well is, you know, how do you make a difference in the world if you're not first working on yourself? Like, change happens from within first, and so we have been very blessed to be able to create a program that allows us to be able to create the space for all of these women to start working on themselves, and that's choosing different topics that we all maybe have struggled with and things that, that we need help and growth in areas of our lives. And then also being able to walk together in that. So it's a journey not only individually, but as a group as well. And then how does that go beyond these walls? How does that carry out into something that's so much further and out into society to be able to eventually, for those of us that are able to get out, to bridge that gap, like D'Amico was saying, and to become a productive member of society. So it's an incredible opportunity.
What are your hopes for the future going forward?
Program expand. We have a couple of core group members with the ability to get out of prison. So I want to see the program expand outside of this place and be able to provide women with different resources once they get out of prison. And also help the kids of those incarcerated individuals, because they're important also. They're our future.
Absolutely. Thank you.